Now, what you just saw was a major bozo no-no at Durham Cathedral. I was there in the early morning, relatively early morning. It was just a hair after 9 o'clock, I think, in the morning. And I went and saw, sat in St. Cuthbert's tomb, which they also call that area, sometimes they call that area the Feretory. In fact, later, later that morning, I was actually able to attend Holy Communion. They held Holy Communion at that altar in that tomb area. But I was able to sit there, and there were basically, you know, there were almost no people around, and there were no of these verger monitors, invigilator types around. And I was just sitting here quietly, and the organ is often playing because they have a series of organists, and they rehearse, you know, on the organs. And there's about three different organs that they use for various services. So at any given time, you're going to more or less likely hear about, you know, you have a better than 50% chance of hearing some sort of organ playing when you're in the cathedral, even if there's not a service going on. So it was a very nice way to spend the time, and I thought, I've got to get a picture of this tomb. And plus then the icon over, the overhead icon over the tomb was, I thought was especially spectacular. It's a variant on the Christ triumphant, in the iconography, that's, they have sort of standard ways that you do icons, and that's a variant on the Christ triumphant icon. So I was glad I got a chance to do that. Now, the later clips in this video it's going to seem somewhat, you know, when all said and done, when you get through this sort of, you know, body of work, a lot of it's kind of repetitive. I mean, I apparently was far more fascinated by the Durham town square, market square, street life than I had fully appreciated at the time. And you see, also understand that the week I was there was the week of the university starting back up. And so you had new students and you had returning students, and the streets were just packed with students. And it's a university town is what it is. You have a cathedral, and there's a cathedral and a university town. There's also some industry there, but it's not in the center of the city. So this is going to be, some of this is going to be a bit repetitive. I shot a lot of this from the window of the Bell's Fish and Chips shop. I think I had my last meal there when I was there. September 30th, I had my last meal there while I was in Durham. And it's great food, and it's reasonably priced, and you can buy local beer, and it's a good place to just people watch. Now, for the sake of the YouTube censors and Google censors and copyright guys going nuts, the music that was in the fish and chip shop, that was a piped in stuff, you know. I'm not using this to make money. And then later on, there's a street busker, a street musician playing outside in the square. I'm not going to edit that man out, you know, even if I knew how. So again, Google, YouTube, whoever runs the show nowadays, don't get your panties in a wad about this, you know. Just let it slide. If you have an issue, take it up with the guy playing the music, not me wandering around in a public space. All right, well, that's sort of like from the sublime to the ridiculous, isn't it? So here's a little more material from Durham. God bless you.
I've been there, guy. I've been you. We all have been. I was fortunate enough to go to university. God bless you there, dude. God bless you. Some aspects, it's like a third world country, isn't it?